Hi, and welcome to our first ever episode of The Wedding Show. We're actually going live on Facebook at the same time here. So each week we hope to offer tips and advice on planning and enjoying your wedding day. From time to time, we hope to have guests join us from every field in the wedding industry. My name is Richard McCarthy. I'm a wedding photographer in the northwest of Ireland in a little place called Tobercurry, County Sligo. And I'm joined here tonight with Michael O'Donovan, expert videographer from The Video Guys.
Hi guys, how are you doing? Michael O'Donovan is my name. Like Richard said, I'm a professional videographer and I've been shooting weddings for, 13, 14, 15 years now? I can't remember. Long time. We've Brian McDermott down the other end of the room. Band.
Yeah, I've been singing at weddings for 15, 16 years as well.
The wedding singer.
Long time.
The wedding singer. You should call yourself the wedding singer. Yeah. Right.
So what's the show about, Richard?
Okay, yeah, well, basically, we plan to talk every week, pick a topic to talk about, wedding related, obviously. And the idea is to kind of to give advice and tips and everything to couples out there, get some input from wedding suppliers out there, the wedding industry, and generally start the conversation on the Irish wedding industry in regards to planning the perfect wedding. So we thought we'd start with at the beginning, I suppose. So basically, if you've gotten engaged or you're planning your wedding, congratulations. And the first thing I suppose you need to do is find your suppliers. So where do you start to find your suppliers? So I suppose the first spot, Mick, would be probably finding them online. Google.
Before you do that, I think you have to set your date.
Well, yes, obviously.
I think, no, it's not obvious. I mean, if you couples out there who haven't been married before.
But if you're all excited, you're just after getting engaged and...
You need to set your date. You need to find your ceremony venue, whether you're going with a church wedding, whether you're going with a civil, whether you want to have it in the back garden or in a forest. And then you need to pick your reception venue, whether it be a hotel or other marquee mm-hmm. job type of thing. And I think those two things you have to pick, you know, within a day or so of each other. You have to set your date.
Yeah.
And then after that, you begin your journey.
But you can start looking. Like, you know, even though if you don't have your date, you can still start looking.
You can. But if you ring up
because
a supplier...
Because how are you
going to
find a hotel?
The first question they're going to ask you is obviously...
How much are you?
Yeah. And why is that, Richard?
It's because it's the first question that comes into everybody's head.
Yeah, but why is that the first question?
Well, because they don't know what else to ask. They haven't been married before.
You let me down there, Richard. I set you up. You see, you're supposed to knock it out of the park.
I'm trying.
But what we tend to ask then as wedding suppliers is, when is the wedding?
Yes.
When is the date?
Yeah.
So
because some suppliers give discounts as well for certain months.
They do?
Do you know what I mean?
Do you?
January, February... November, you know the quiet times, you might get a discount. Well, even hotels give deals.
They do actually midweek weddings. Yeah. So some of the hotels will give midweek. I mean, we offer discounts for a midweek wedding, and we offer discounts for January and February weddings as well.
Yeah. So, you have peak times and you have off peak weddings. Like we say, you've certain days of the year where you're pretty much sure that you're going to get a lot of inquiries, like the June Bank Holiday weekend or New Year's Eve and things like that.
Yeah.
So the rest of the time, we'll say, is generally off-peak. It can be, this time of the year, for example, it'll be quite quiet. And you're also, a lot of time, it's weather dependent.
Yeah.
So it depends on when people are going to pick that date.
Okay.
You know? Yeah. So I think, we'll say, starting with, going online and Googling and searching and the whole lot, I suppose the best advice we can give in regards to that is, especially with Google, you type in, for example, wedding videographer, you'll get hundreds and hundreds of wedding videographers coming up in the Google search, and you get a lot of ads and stuff like that. So I think it's important to kind of narrow that down and get the local ones.
What if you key in local wedding videographers? Will that help?
I don't know. I don't think it does. I think you basically need to put in like a wedding videographer Sligo, wedding videographer.
Yeah, okay.
You know, wherever you're looking for that photographer.
Google does it by keying in local wedding supplier or wedding photographer, videographer, band, whatever. You don't get... Google doesn't figure out where you are and
If you're doing it on your phone, it knows where you are.
Right.
Generally, on your laptop, it won't know for definite where exactly you are, because unless your laptop is a new state-of-the-art one with Wi-Fi location or something or other.
Right, okay.
You know, so I think a lot of laptops, generally, they don't know exactly where they are. They have a pinpoint that you could be somewhere in the Sligo area.
Right, okay.
Or you know, from that sense. So I'd say it's easier to be sure and basically put in, like if you're getting married in Sligo, if you're getting married in Mayo, if you get married in Dublin, to put that into the search, and that's
so Google is, Google is your first port call.
Yeah.
Okay. After Google, what do you reckon?
Well, this time of year is very popular is the wedding fairs.
Right.
So you'd have different wedding fairs. So you'd have wedding fairs and wedding expos. So what would be the main difference between the wedding fairs and wedding expos, Brian?
Fairs and expos. Well, the fairs usually happen in the hotels. And they're smaller.
Yeah.
You know, the expos, you know, some people don't like them because they're too big.
Yeah.
You know, so like the expo is, I suppose it's harder work as well. You know, if you're looking for a photographer at an expo in Dublin, you could meet seven or eight of them.
Yeah, exactly. And the thing is, we say nearly all suppliers, like including ourselves, like we do cover nationwide. We say to brides, look, you know, it doesn't matter where you get married. We do tend to cover it in, you know, anywhere in Ireland. Yeah. And that's what tends to happen a lot with the expos. Is it's more nationwide. It's you have a lot of suppliers coming from all over the country to do expos in Dublin. Or one difference to that would be the Northwest Wedding Expo, which was on
here
on
January. Expo, yeah.
Which, you know, featured mostly local suppliers, didn't it?
Yeah, I think so. I think it would have done, yeah. Yeah. Majority were local suppliers or within 80 miles or 100 miles of this exact spot, basically. Yeah.
So it was kind of locally based, but it was a big expo. There was a lot of suppliers there. You know, it would have been as big as any of the expos that I've done in Dublin. There'd be a lot more going on, we'll say, with the expos in Dublin, like all these big fashion shows and stuff like that. But I think the premise was there that, you know, you were dealing with local suppliers.
But do brides and grooms make bookings on the day at a wedding fair, realistically?
I think so.
Or are they just there to meet people? And
no, I think the idea of the wedding fair stroke the expos is giving the suppliers, i.e. the service providers, a shop window to put their stuff in front of potential brides in the space of 4 hours in the case of a wedding fair, or in the case of an expo, maybe 12 hours spread over two days. Yeah. And I think one of the things that sometimes doesn't happen is couples don't tend to book on the day, which is a pity, because an awful lot of the suppliers, one, go to a lot of trouble and a lot of expense to provide a service and to put their stuff in front of couples, but also they offer substantial discounts.
Yeah, you generally get a lot of discounts, we'll say, at the expos or even at the wedding fairs.
If a couple walked into the expo that we attended in January with maybe $2,000 or $3,000 in their back pocket, and they went in and they booked a photographer, a video guy, a band, maybe their florist, the car guy, and I don't know, maybe the cake person and the ceremony singer. That's the majority of all the...
It's a lot of decisions to make on the day.
A lot of decisions to make one day. And the other side of that as well is, we'll say, my general would say feeling
we already said that the first port of call is Google, so they would have Googled the various suppliers that would be attending the expo, so they would have done the research.
Let's say you go to see
wedding videographer A at an expo, and then you meet wedding videographer B, and he's quite nice, and
but they're all nice, we're all lovely,
but they haven't done the research on that person, so they're not going to turn
it's
around
the photographers
and go, okay,
that have, you know, they have the bad rep, the photographers.
You want to start that now. Wait till episode 2 for that,
at least 2 or 3 for that, lads.
So I think we'll say the big thing about wedding fairs this time of year is that and wedding expos is that they are seasonal. Most of them are in January, February. A lot of the wedding expos already are, and wedding fairs are nearly over now at this stage.
But if you book your supplier at the expo or at the wedding fairs, then you've got until the next one to save.
And the Diamond Coast.
Big shout out to the Diamond Coast. Yes, Mary Clark. On, when is it? The 19th of March.
Yeah, that's kind of unusual to have a wedding.
It is, but I'm looking forward to it, because we've that little gap from the wedding fairs, because the last couple of weeks has been wedding fair, wedding expo, wedding fair, wedding fair, wedding fair. And we've now a little gap to kind of to meet new brides as well.
Like, be full of chat that day.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I won't shut up that day. Definitely, come talk to me.
We're going to do a show on the day of the...
we'll do a show live.
Do a show.
Are we going to go live, though?
Yeah, we'll go
hopefully.
Live.
Okay.
We'll go live all the time.
We'll have to get Mary to upgrade the broadband there at the hotel.
We'll have to get Mary in next week, maybe. Actually, hi, Mary.
The fibre broadband there. I think
Mary, we'll have to get you on next week, Mary.
Yeah.
So I think going from that, then, we'll say, you know, if the wedding fair season is over, where do brides go to find more information?
Oh, well, other than Google, then, you've got Facebook. There are a number of groups on Facebook and my wedding store here in the store. Yeah. We have a number of exhibitors.
Oh, that's we're actually here right now. Sorry, we never mentioned that.
Did the big group, so help them getting married.
Yeah, and you've got
and it's helped me. I'm getting there's two.
Help
and there's one. There's one about
married.
What was the one you said you were going
I
to start?
Setting up. Help me. I am married.
That'd be a good one. That'd be
quite
good.
That'd be full of people,
yeah.
But I think the main kind of advice we want to give kind of on the Facebook groups is that they are a platform to get information, but our biggest fear is that it's becoming kind of a price war where people are literally putting up that I got this cake and it only cost me 100 euros and someone else going up saying that, well, our cake is going to cost us 900 euros and they're not putting it in context.
No, they're not, because what tends to happen there is the girl who puts up I got a wedding cake for 100 euros could be a wedding cake feeding 50 people.
Yeah.
And the girl that got our guy that got a wedding cake for 900 and 900 is completely off the wall. Let's say 500, 400 euros. They could be feeding 250 people.
Yeah.
One could be made out of fruit and one could be made out of
it
chalk.
It might be just a horrible cake. Some cakes are horrible.
No, they're not.
Some cakes are horrible.
They're not.
I've never come across a bad
wedding cake. Yeah, I tasted bad wedding cakes.
No.
I don't like
Well, I don't. I tend to stick with the fruit, and the fruit cakes are always lovely.
Fruit cakes
are horrible. We won't argue over wedding cakes, guys. Okay.
You can't say there's no
By the way, if there's anybody out there who wants to send us some wedding cake for next week, we'd be more than happy to taste your wedding cake. So if there's any cake people out there and they want to send us some samples of their wedding cakes, we'll be delighted to have a nice cup of tea next week.
Ailish, that's Coke in the cup.
Brian won't drink tea unless he has a biscuit or a piece of wedding cake.
I didn't even get a cup of tea, Ailish.
Ailish from VIP Weddings on Facebook.
Hey, Ailish.
Hey.
She said something
fantastic.
Nice. She had something nice in her cup the other night, her and Stephen at the Hunt's Ball.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
They just came back from their honeymoon. They got married, I don't know, 20 years ago. I did their video.
Have they got their video?
Yeah, they did. I knew that he was going to say that.
Can't win.
Now, moving on. What else?
Okay. So I think just the last word.
Just one other thing. Whether it's you're researching your wedding supplier or your service provider on Google, on Facebook, at a wedding fair, etc.
Yeah.
You have to speak to them face to face.
Yeah, I think definitely.
You have to talk to them over the phone at the very least.
Yes, exactly. Because I think that you have to realize, like, from our perspective anyway, we're sharing the most intimate moments of their day. And you need to be able to get on with your photographer. You need to be able to get on with your
videographer. I don't know about that now, Richard. I don't know what kind of photographs you'd be taking.
Well, the romantic moments earlier on in the day. We'll put it that way. You know, keep it clean now. Keep it clean.
Keep it country.
It's very important you get on with your suppliers. And I think there's nothing more important for me is that if I'm talking to a bride, I can find out what she likes and find out what exactly, how her wedding day is planned. And how, she wants to capture that day. Right. So, like, it's you were saying before, like, we say that, the photographer's job is to direct the day.
No, I didn't say that.
Well,
No, I said part of their job is to help the bride, is to guide the bride and groom through their day.
Yeah.
Which is different to directing the day. I mean, there is a certain timeline that the bride and groom need to follow we would recommend following because they have to be at the hotel at a certain time. They have only a certain time to get family shots taken.
Exactly,
they need to be at the church at a certain time.
Yeah,
if the wedding's at 1 o'clock, they can't arrive at 1:45 and hope everything's going to be cushy.
Yeah. So I think that's something we are going to cover in a later episode is kind of the wedding timeline.
Will be one of the topics that we do cover.
Yeah, just to let the folks at home out there, we will have other suppliers, other service providers joining us here on the show.
Did I say at the start?
No. You did, yeah. No, just to reiterate that they will be joining us just to stir the pot a bit more.
Yeah.
So it won't always be us guys. So if there's anybody out there that would like to get involved, then please get in touch.
We have a seat warm, ready for you and everything.
The hot seat.
We'll just leave Richard at home.
I think I'll stay at home the next time. I suppose most importantly, we'll say, when you do find that perfect supplier, when you find a supplier that you really want, when's the best time to book?
Straight away. Yeah, why wait?
Because you might have the money.
It's not always about money.
Most suppliers, if you really want somebody and they know you want them, they'll deal with you.
Yeah, absolutely.
Or they'll try their best to hold a date or something, But don't hang around because you know, you wait another 2 weeks. And it's the way it happens, you know, you might get one bride looking for you for the 2nd of August and a week later, an hour later, you get a phone call.
Yeah, that's happened.
And then
before,
you mightn't
yeah.
get anybody for 3 months. But, yeah. you know, if you really want...
Tell the story about the bands that you told us earlier.
Which one was that?
You know, about the 10 bands. You know, if you're booking...
Oh, yeah, well, it's just, yeah, if you're looking
And
at,
this goes across the board for photographers, videos, everything.
Okay, yeah. Say you're getting married 2019 and you get a list of 10 bands from a hotel. Chances are 10 of them are available now, right? Mm-hmm. But the closer it gets... it gets chipped away at that list and the better ones start getting booked up, you know, so there's absolutely no advantage to leaving it, you know, and sitting back and go, oh, we must book the band soon or do it now, like get it done. Yeah. The bigger supplier, you know, band photographer, videographer, ceremony singer, the guys that can only take one gig in a day.
Yeah.
You have to get them.
Yeah, absolutely.
The,
yeah.
the dress people can take more than one. The florists can take more than one. The cake people can take.
Generally, the better ones go first.
But do you not take more than one booking a day and you send your cardboard cutout?
The Brian McDermott tribute band. Yeah.
Don't give them ideas. Don't give them ideas. But I think that would say, you know, finding that perfect supplier and the whole lot. The other.
Imelda. Landmark Imelda.
Hi Imelda.
Hi Imelda.
How are you?
we just do that every time somebody joins us.
Congratulations on winning, is it Connacht Venue of the Year? Or is it Irish Wedding Venue of the Year?
I'm not sure. Congratulations to the Landmark Hotel.
Yes,
yeah.
definitely. Yeah. Lovely venue. So I think we'll say from, once you do have your supplier in the whole lot, one section we've completely forgot about, and it'd be one area that I tend to get a lot of my weddings from is word of mouth. And you'd be the same, and Brian, you'd be the same as well. Like we'll say, a lot of brides would come to see you at previous weddings.
Not word of mouth, but with bands, it's people that have seen you.
Yeah.
Because if we go out on Friday night, you're playing to maybe 200 guests. Mm-hmm. So there's going to be 5 or 6 in that, you know.
I did a wedding one night in the Sligo Park. Mm-hmm. And the couple whose wedding it was, apart from them,
Waterside Venue of the Year, the Landmark one.
There was seven.
We were very close to the water a few years ago.
There were seven other brides at that wedding whose wedding I had done.
Yeah,
seven.
So yeah, seven other brides, seven other couples whose wedding. And the great thing was
the seven brothers as well.
No. The great thing was that, you know, some of them had kids.
Yeah.
You know, people who had done weddings for 10 years ago, mm-hmm. they might have had a 6-year-old or an 8-year-old at the wedding, which was great.
Yeah.
And they'd introduced me as Michael, the guy that shot their wedding video, you know, the one that you're wearing out, you know, constantly or watching constantly, that type of thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Dave joined us, DJ Groove.
Hey, Dave. Seriously, the... word of mouth is massive, I think.
Absolutely.
It's a great recommendation from people.
You were saying earlier on about...
And wedding suppliers, other wedding suppliers.
Yes, exactly. Like, it's lovely to kind of hear kind of, you know, when you're talking to a bride and, oh, this person said you did their wedding and they were happy with you, you know? And it makes the job so much easier because there's that level of trust there.
Yeah.
And you were even saying earlier on about how, you know, you've done weddings where... The oldest sister got married and now the younger sister's getting married.
Yeah.
And, you know, you've done generations of a family like in that regard, you know.
Yeah.
So I think word of mouth is a big
I think the hotel recommendations and the other wedding supplier recommendations.
Yes.
I get a lot of recommendations from yourself and from other photographers. Mm-hmm. And I recommend other photographers as well as you, you know, to couples.
Who do you recommend first?
Well, people ask the whole time, who do you recommend? And I list off the few lads that I really enjoy working with and whose work I know is brilliant, and let them off.
Yeah.
Let them do their own research.
Yeah, every photographer has a different style. So
yeah, absolutely.
There's no point in, you know.
Some of them could be booked. Some of them, you know, mightn't be available for other reasons.
Absolutely.
They might be taking holidays. You know, some guys take holidays, whoever they are.
Do they?
Some, yeah.
But I think it does help when you have suppliers that know the venue. They know, like, that the hotels recommend you, for example, you know, that you've worked there before. You work well with the hotel. You work well with the other suppliers. Like, we all have to work together on the day, you know, and the bride should not have to worry about us working together well. So, like, that should be kind of a given in regards to kind of, you know, suppliers working with each other, you know?
Yeah.
So I think we'll say we've covered kind of quite a lot of, I think we've covered every kind of aspect of finding suppliers. The one that we didn't mention is where we are right now, which is the wedding store in Clooney in County Sligo. For those out, you know, who might know where Clooney in County Sligo is.
For all you folks living in Australia.
Yes, exactly. If you want to come visit.
How are you doing?
But it's to me, I'm one of the suppliers here. Mick and Brian are the owners of it. And
I think Mary's running the show.
Well, yeah, I think we work for Mary now at this stage. Yeah. Hey, Mary.
So hopefully Mary's tuned in as well. But I think we'll say from your perspective, the reason I'm in here is because it's like a wedding fair all year round, which is what I like. People can come in and see my work and they can see what
you meet
what
brides
I do.
Here quite
and
often.
I meet brides here. Yeah, exactly. So it's a great meeting point as well.
But do you meet every couple?
I try to. If at all possible, I'd love to meet, because I need to know that, you know, that we work together, you know, that there's not going to be any issues, you know. Mm. And I think that would say from my perspective, you know, I do silly things like go to rehearsals and stuff like that.
Yeah.
You know, the day before the wedding, because I want to meet the family and I want to make sure everything's absolute, that I get on with everybody.
Yeah.
But
what happens if you have a Friday and Saturday then?
If I have a Friday,
that's a busy week. Like, are you at two rehearsals?
Yeah. Generally, I find that we'll say, look, if I can't go to rehearsal because I'm at a wedding, you know, that's a given. But like if the rehearsal's on the Thursday and I have a Friday, Saturday wedding, then that's okay, you know.
Well, from now on, you'll be able to get them to do a live, a Facebook live or record it.
Yeah, it would be not a bad idea. But I think the point I was trying to make was that, you know, literally speak to your suppliers, find out exactly what you want, make sure that they're delivering kind of what you're looking for.
Yeah, but a lot of brides don't know what they want. A lot of brides are at different stages of the journey. So they turn up, or they ring you, or they speak to you at a wedding fair, or they message you, or they email you. And like you said earlier on, the first thing they ask is, how much are you?
Yeah, I agree.
Only because they don't know what else to ask.
They don't know what else to ask. But I think that's not an excuse that we should use. I think suppliers should ask those questions.
That brings up a question. So what should they ask you first?
They should ask, you know, say what coverage you do all day. Like, are you there for the whole day? Are you going to be there till the first dance? Are you going to be finished at dinner? Are you going to be at the bride's house? Are you going to go to the groom's house? How do we get our images? Are we going to get digital images afterwards? Are we going to get a disc? Are we going to get a USB?
And expanding on that a little bit, what's something important that's different between photographers that brides don't ask? Like, that they don't seem to realize? Like, that images, how to get their, like, is there a few things that brides don't know about that makes a big difference between you and another guy?
I think it's the stuff in the background, as in, like, do they have backup cameras? Like, do they have more than one camera? What happens on the day? What happens if he's sick?
Brian, will you check that? Just check that camera, will you? Because I heard a click. It might be something else. It might have gone off. I'm not sure how long we're running. But one of the things that Brian brought up there about what things they should ask is, I think one of the first things that they should ask is, you know, how long you've been, have you done a wedding before? I mean, you do come across the situation where you might have a photographer who is a photographer but is not a wedding photographer in my case. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Or you might have the one thing I always recommend to
people.
Is there
anything wrong with that? Everybody
has to start somewhere.
Yeah.
But like we say, with every supplier,
There is something wrong with that. And I'll tell you, in my opinion, what's wrong with that is, like I said earlier on, the photographer and the video guy are there for the whole day.
It's like the photographer day.
Right? No. The photographer and the video guy are there for the whole day. They're one of the few services that are there from the early morning till late in the evening. So they've seen every aspect of the wedding day.
Yeah.
Right? Some of the photographers who aren't wedding photographers per se, they could be great photographers and they take great pictures, but they may not guide the bride in relation to the timeline of the day.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
And that's my only issue with them. I've worked with great photographers who are photographers. I'm not saying that wedding photographers aren't photographers.
Really? Yeah, let's just say that.
I'm just getting worried now.
Singing out a tune, Brian, while they're arguing.
yeah, we can have a tune, yes.
Well, it's only the weekend.
So I think that, you know, from every supplier's perspective, look, we all want to do a good job. We all want to deliver
something. Yeah, well, nobody starts off the day saying, I want to do a crappy job.
No, but I think that, you know, if you're not preparing, if you fail to prepare, prepare to fail. So, like, if you aren't, you know, making sure that you have asked loads of questions, that you know exactly what's going to happen on the day.
So that goes for the bride and the groom. So that goes for the couples as well.
Ways,
yeah. They need to ask questions. They need, you know, what coverage do you provide?
Yeah.
Do you have backup for your equipment? You know, do you go to the bride's house, like you said?
Yeah,
do you cover the groom's house? Do you stay after the first dance?
Yeah.
How many cameras do you use? Mm-hmm. You know, that type of stuff.
Yeah. But look, that applies to videographers, it applies to bands, it applies to every type of supplier out there. Yeah. You know, ask the questions. If you don't know what to ask, the supplier should be asking questions.
We need to make it clear now as well that we're coming at it from a photographer's point of view, and a videographer's point of view. The band, you know, there's not you don't have as much contact with the bride and groom.
We don't argue with anyone. We just roll in.
You don't have as much contact with the couples as we do.
Do they like?
No, we
say,
don't.
Can you like sing my song, or can you sing the song? Or
we don't really need to. Like, the only thing that a band really needs to know in advance is the first dance. You know, in case they want us to learn a certain song. But the best thing after that is leave it up to the band.
Right. Yeah.
You know, you'll get a couple or they'll go, oh, well, we don't like, can you not do this song? And that's okay. Maybe one or two songs.
Yeah.
But they're going to pick out all the cheesy numbers that nobody likes in the band playing either. Mm-hmm. But they fill the floor.
They fill the floor. Yeah. Yeah.
You know, so if you start, you know, taking out the songs like that, you're on the risk of having the floor empty, you know, so just... And it's in the band's interest to have the floor full as well, because that's where we get our work. 90% of it comes from having a good night, or, you know.
So it comes back to what you were saying before about going to see the band. Go and see a band
when you're
live.
Booking a band, you have to go and see them. See
absolutely,
them
makes sense. Okay, I think we have talked to death the topic of finding suppliers.
Yes. Finding suppliers.
So we're going to do this every week, aren't we? We're going to try and give kind of the top tip of the week.
Well, my one on finding your wedding band.
Okay.
Let me see, top tip. Well, just, you know, check out bands online and you'll get a feel for the ones you like, but then go and see them live at a wedding before you book. You know, even showcases are okay, but that's a band doing their best bits. Try and catch them live at a wedding. And any good band won't have a problem with you coming to see them live.
Yeah.
If they don't want you to come and see them live, it's a little bit of a red flag anyway.
Yeah.
You know.
Okay.
That'd be my tip.
My tip of the week would be, do your research. Make sure to check out your supplier. Have a look at his work or her work. If you can, you know, if you can talk to previous brides or grooms that have had them for their wedding, it helps, you know, because what you see in, like, from my perspective in photographs, what you see in the pictures might not reflect what the day was like. So, like, you could have a photographer who does fantastic work, but the bride and groom didn't get on with him. And that kind of ruined the day. So I think it's very important to kind of do your research, ask questions, and from the supplier side, don't be afraid to ask questions of the bride and groom as well.
Just going to jump in there. I think we have, I can never, is it Tomas or Thomas from the Diamond Coast?
Hey, Thomas.
After jumping in.
Tomas.
We're going, I think Mary calls.
Mark is after joining us.
Yeah. We'll be down in the Diamond Coast on the 19th of March, and we're going to run the show from there as well. So that'll be good. Hi, Mark.
Can you ask her permission?
Mark, is that okay? Or Tomas, is that okay if we do a show from the Diamond Coast?
We're doing the show.
Let us know. Let us know online, will you? My top tip, I think, for today is, if you are attending a wedding fair like that, and or you've spoken to someone previous to attending a wedding fair, book them as soon as, if you're confident that they're going to do a great job for you, then pay.
Thomas said, great idea. So we're on to the Diamond Coast.
Excellent. Okay. You know, book them on the day, don't delay it, because there's no point in delaying. If you think their work is good and you think you're going to get on with them, there's no point in delaying.
That's true. Yeah, I suppose.
Book your suppliers.
You're on the risk.
And then, you know, there are certain things you can enjoy. I mean, the booking other things you can enjoy as well. But you got to save then, basically. Because weddings aren't cheap.
That's it. Credit union loan.
Credit union
credit
loan. Great
union
place.
Loan.
We'll have to get the credit union on one of the days. Plug there for the credit union.
So, finishing up the show.
Yeah, finishing up the show. I have a little ditty here.
So, and just for anybody on Facebook Live, we're recording this as well, so the full episode will be online tomorrow.
Okay.
Hopefully.
No pressure.
So cue me. So that's it for another episode of The Wedding Show.
But we have to, sorry, are we taking comments? Mark from Pink Lime said, top tip, tell them to stay away from Dundee.
Yes.
Why, Mark? Yeah, we'll have to get Mark in as well.
We'll have to get Mark.
Yeah, Mark.
Yeah, yeah,
we'll have to get Mark in one of the days.
Yeah.
But yeah, look, we better. Are we going to continue on or are we going to finish up?
I think we have to go home.
Okay. So that's it for another episode of The Wedding Show. We're back again next week. Thanks to Brian and Richard for joining us, and especially to you guys for tuning in. Remember to leave any comments or questions or subjects that you'd like us to cover in the comment section below, and we will respond to them one way or the other. Or you can get in touch
one
with us.
Can you just let me finish?
Take me ages to do this. If you'd like to get in touch privately, you can email us or you can contact us here in the store. So until next week.
Bye for now.
Bye for
now. See you later.
Bye.
Happy wedding, planet.